Let us close the eyes, remembering God and the Masters, offering our prayer. Om Sahana Vavatu, Sahano Bhunaktu, Sahaviryam Karavavahe. तेजस्वी नावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति 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 मे द डिवाइन प्रोटेक्ट अस ऑल मे वी एंजॉय फूड टुगेदर मे वी मेडिटेट एंड प्रे टुगेदर May our study bring brilliance to us. May there be no conflict among us. May there be peace within and everywhere. Om, Amen. I bow to one God who is formless, all pervading. I bow to all the saints and sages of all times and places, and I bow to lineage of Kriya Yoga masters. I bow to each one of you. We'll begin with a prayer. आयुर्नश्यति पश्यतां प्रतिदिनं याति क्षयं यौवनं प्रत्यायान्तगता पुनर्न दिवसा कालो जगत भक्षकः लक्ष्मीस्तोयतरङ्गभङ्ग चपला विद्युच्चलं जीवनं तस्मात् त्वां शरणागतं शरणद त्वं रक्ष रक्षाधुना ओ गॉड आई परसीव लाइफ इज डिमिनिशिंग एवरी डे यूथफुल स्टेज इज पासिंग अवे The day which is gone is not going to come back. Everything is being swallowed by the time spirit. Material prosperity is impermanent, like ripples on water. Human life is temporary, as if lightning in the sky. Therefore, I have come to take refuge at your holy feet. O Lord, please protect me now. Good morning and welcome to our satsang. A lot of people are worried these days as what would happen after the pandemic phase is over, economy will collapse, people will have problem with food and so on. Let me ask you today a simple question. Are you alive? You will say, what an absurd question it is. Of course, I am alive. Are you really alive? Or you are living like a living dead body? I had one friend in my college days. We used to call him living dead body because he was walking, he was working, studying, but everything looks like he had no life. However, who is a living person? A living person is the one who is breathing, Now let me ask you, do you remember that you are breathing? We all are breathing, but we don't remember it. We forget it. Remember, every person wants to live. No one likes to die. But we have to think, are we really living or we are dying every moment? Generally, with each breath, the duration of our life is diminishing like a lamp or a candle. When the wax or oil is diminishing, life of candle or the lamp is also diminishing. But in spiritual terms, every breath is a new life. So, a living person lives in present moment. But we all live either in the memories of the past or in the golden dreams of the future. It is only towards the end of life that one feels that the whole life has been spent in futile worries and we have never lived our life. So, spirituality is another name for conscious living in present. There is a beautiful verse in the scripture, Gate shoko na kartavya, bhavishyam naiva chintayet, vartamanena kalena pravartante vichakshanaha. Gate shoko na kartavya. For that which has gone, one need not lament. Bhavishyam naiva chintayet, nor even to be worried for future. Vartamanena kalena pravartante vichakshanaha. Vichakshana, intelligent people always get involved in new activity in present moment. Vartamanakal. They live in present. I heard from Guruji many times when he says, I live from breath to breath. I live from moment to moment. And I don't waste single moment, single second of time. As humans, we tend to spend a lot of time in our past or in future. We spend too much time thinking about what was and what could have been. We analyze, we debate, and we spend more and more time projecting into future and wondering what might happen. The present moment is the only moment available to us, and it is the door to all moments. Remember, past is gone. We cannot do anything with that. Whether it was good or bad, it is just past. Future has not yet come. What we are doing today at this moment is going to become our future. So, either we live in the past or in the future. That's why it is said, either we love to live in the tomb or in the womb. How can we live in present moment? There is always a reason to smile. Remember, whether there is difficulty, whether there is prosperity or adversity, there is always a reason to smile. And plenty of reasons we can find. Each day is full of endless possibilities. And being the day as a gift, so we should begin our day with a smile. Smile when you brush your teeth. Look at your own face, a smile, because it is not your face, it is face of God. Look at the other people feeling presence of divine. Smile at them. When we go to the work, smile at other people, our colleagues. So when we begin the day with a smile, the whole day we continue smiling. And you are in control of your attitude every morning, because when we get up in the morning, we are completely fresh. Our mind is more peaceful, and same state of mind we have to carry throughout the day. And when we start our morning with a smile, with positive attitude, with optimistic attitude, then surely the whole day we remain in that mood. Why we live in present? Remember, we have lots of possessions. We try to possess more and more. We try to possess material, people, objects, and so on. Your possession force you to live in present, because they pull you back. So removing objects associated with our past memories or lives makes us free to stop living in the past, and we start living in the present. It happens very often that we have some bad experience. We have some memories which are negative memories, and they're haunting our mind constantly, and we entertain them. But if we try to disassociate with those memories or those objects of our hatred or anger, it helps us to start living in the present. So long as we are trying to be attached with the past memories, past objects, we cannot make us ourselves free. So let's not possess them. Let's try to detach from them. And that is the way we can live in present moment. It is said that there is no U-turn in life. Sometimes it happens we are driving on the highway and we forget to take a turn. What happens? We have to drive a little longer and then we can come back, detour. So there is a U-turn also, you can come back. But in life there is no U-turn. The moment which is gone forever. So life does not give you a second chance. You take the first chance. So don't miss it. Every moment is precious and important. And try to dream big. What happens that we don't dream. We think, okay, I'm happy. As a spiritual person, we make this mistake. We think that we are spiritual. We should be content. So we are happy with this. So we do not set our goals, or you can say higher goals. If we do not dream big, we cannot achieve big. So here I am talking about setting the goal, short-term goal and long-term goals. Long-term goal, permanent goal, the highest goal is to achieve samadhi in this lifetime through our kriya practice. And short-term goals can be our professional life, family life, or many things we want to achieve. So we have to do both. So dream big so that you can become a big person. But remember, life is not going to give you a second chance. So grab it in the first attempt. So we should always set some goals and plans for the future. Whether it works or not, different. But make the plan and work today. Working hard today is always the first step towards realizing our dreams for tomorrow. But don't allow dreaming about tomorrow to replace living in today. And very often we do that. We start dreaming for tomorrow. But we have to dream for now, first step, and be here. Another thing, we should practice let go. It was a beautiful technique we learned during our sales and marketing career. It was to let go. Whatever happened, it happened. So let it go. Getting past our past, this is called in another way. And if you remember in the Holy Bible, Jesus said to his disciples, when they wanted to follow Jesus, Jesus told, let the dead bury the dead and follow me. Means, whatever is gone, your past is past. You just forget it and just in this present moment, come with me and follow me. If we remain in anger, if we keep resentment towards other fellow beings because of some past hurts and we don't forgive them, then we always are in trouble. So better to forgive whatever past hurts we have and we should move on. We should not linger on the past. The harm was their fault. Whatever fault was there, we should forget it and move on. That is what is living in present. Because if we do not move on and still get stuck up with the old memories, then it impacts our today and present moment. There's a beautiful saying. People say, don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Why? We worry about the future. We cannot fully appreciate today if we worry too much about tomorrow. So if we are into future, we cannot appreciate what is present today. So we need to realize that tomorrow is going to happen whether we worry or not about it. It's going to happen. There's no need to worry. And since worry has never accomplished anything for anybody, we need to redirect our mental energy to the present moment, to some positive constructive work. The best way to keep our mind focused and live in present moment, as Guruji has taught, always be conscious of your breath. And this is the technique all our Kriya masters have emphasized. What is the meaning of remaining conscious of breath? To keep a little attention on top of the head and feel that God is breathing. As Gurudev used to say, showing the fontanel, God is constantly pulling your breath. Gurudev said, if God does not breathe from top of the head, then you are not alive. So always remain conscious. To remain conscious of breath does not mean you have to focus and you have to concentrate on that. To remain conscious means just a part of that. You are aware that the breath is moving in and out every moment. This is the best and easiest practice to remain in present moment. Always remember, yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, and today is a gift, and that is why it is called present. Gift is also known as present. So today is the present. Have you ever thought of what you would be in 10 years' time? If you have thought and planned, you will start living in present moment, because what you have planned, you have to work now. So your plan today will help you to begin to work on that tomorrow. And remember, tomorrow never comes. Tomorrow never comes means right now we have to take this step. We have to live here. We have to act accordingly. When Arjuna came to the battlefield in the Mahabharata, Battle of Mahabharata, Arjuna came fully prepared. For last 13 years, Arjuna and all his brothers Pandavas, they were preparing for the war because they all knew war was inevitable. Lord Krishna even tried to make peace with Kauravas and Pandavas, but it did not work. So When Arjuna came with all preparations into the battlefield of Mahabharata, which is called Dharma Kshetra Kurukshetra. And he told Lord Krishna that I want to see with whom I am going to fight. So please take my chariot in the middle of the two armies. And when he looked at the army from both sides, he got dejected, he got depressed, and he was not in a state of fighting. So he told Lord Krishna that I cannot kill my own kiths and kins. They are my relatives. How can I kill my uncle, my brother, my grandfather? I sat in his lap, played with him. How can I kill them? Then he told that I consider it better to live my life by begging alms than killing people of my own clan and enjoy the happiness of the state. Even if I win, I won't be able to enjoy that kingdom. I don't know whether I will be victorious or I will lose. And if there is a war, the woman of the family will become corrupt and give birth to adulterated children, and so on. So he gave so many different logics, many questions, and very beautiful logical questions, no doubt. Now the question is, if we consider the state of mind of Arjuna in the battlefield with ourselves, we are also in the same position. Just like Arjuna, who came prepared for the battle. So there was nothing in his mind except to begin the war and win the war. And knowing that Lord Krishna was on his side, becoming his chariot driver, there was no doubt about the victory. But the moment he looked at both the armies and this attachment came back that they are my own people, he forgot his duty. And all these different questions he posed to Lord Krishna, they appeared in Arjuna's mind because he was thinking about the future. Remember, this is a very important point. Why these questions appeared in his mind and why he got dejected, he was not able to fight, because he started thinking about the future. And what was his duty? His duty was to cooperate with God in the work of religious establishment by fighting with the enemy and not considering the outcome of the war. Because before coming to battlefield, he had enough time, many years, for all these thoughts, these questions, logics, what will happen, what will not happen. But the moment he came fully prepared and he was just about to begin the war, that was not the moment to think about the future or the past. That was the moment. Only one thought should have been in Arjuna's mind, that in front of me there is enemy and I have to kill the enemy to establish righteousness, and Lord is with me. But he forgot and he started thinking about the future, and that's how his mind became more restless, and he said that I don't know what is my duty. Please guide me in the second chapter. So when he started thinking about the result of the war, all these problems started. So also we do become worried about the future. Don't we also do the same in our daily lives? All our attention, all our energy is spent whether the result of my action, which I am doing now, will be favorable to me or not. Look, when we start our action, when we have to be in present, we don't need to think about whether it will be favorable or not favorable. We have to just do that. That is what is living in present moment. But we start thinking about future, and that is the reason we are not able to focus on our job, our work, and we are not happy. There was a monk, and one mother went to him. She had some problem with his son. The son was married, but the son didn't get any child. So she requested monk that, could you bless him? My son is 28 years old and he doesn't have any son or any child. So can you please bless him? The monk told, why are you worried about your son? You have a son or not? She said, yes, I do have my son. Then one who does not have a child should be worried about it. Why you are worried? Now one who does not have child should be worried. And why do you become worried about your son? So this is how we always think about future. We think about things which are not yet, or we are worried about other people. I remember in 2005, there was a meeting in our Balighai ashram with all the residents, and I think there were 40 residents were present. So for the meeting, we went up to the classroom on the second floor in our main building area. We all walked, climbed up, and later on Guruji came to the class, and first question he asked, did you see the fallen green leaf of nearby coconut tree on the staircase while coming to the class? Most of us answered in no. I had seen it, but I did not pay attention and bother to remove it because I thought I was going to be late in the class. Then Guruji said, this is how we are living in ashram. We are not conscious of what is happening around us. It was not about the leaf. It was about how consciously we are living. Not only in the ashram, but in our daily life also, we need to live a conscious life. We live with a conditioned mind. And I have observed it many times that in guided meditation, when I give the command to students, turn to the right, and they turn to the left. When I say that stretch the legs or stand up or lie down, but when I say stretch your legs, they immediately lie down because their minds are conditioned. We do not really listen to others. We don't really see things as they are. Our mind is so scattered, restless, that we behave like blind and deaf. And this conditioning starts right from our birth. In the ashram, or homestead ashram, close to my room, there is a common restroom. And despite the note written on the door, please do not slam the door. I hear door slamming sound each time. Because we are not conscious. How can we live conscious life? Gurudev always said, watch your breath. When we are conscious of breath, we become observer. It is called Sakshi. We are witness, witnessing every single breath moving in and out constantly. So when we are conscious of breath, we are Sakshi or we are Drashta. Drashta means observer. A Drashta or observer is not a Karta. Karta means doer. If you are not the doer, then any action being performed is Kriya. But if you think that you are doing some action, you are a doer and you will get the result of that action. But if you are not doer, that it's not me, it's power of God who is doing everything, then it becomes Kriya. It will not transform into karma to give you result. so you will not be bound by its result. Kriya has a natural function, it's not the result for future. When you are conscious of breath, you are conscious of your mind, and you can watch every single thought flashing into the mind. All feelings of likes and dislikes, all emotions, like a movie being played on the screen. You don't swing between high and low tides, which are known as vrittis of your mind. You will be neutral, you will be balanced, and you will remain at peace. This is what happens when we are conscious of breath. And when we are conscious of breath, we are neither in future nor we are in the past, but we are in the present moment. And when we remain neutral, balanced, at peace, at that time we can experience our real identity, which is mentioned in Yoga Sutra Patanjali, first chapter, third sutra. Tada drashtu swarupe avasthanam means when a person is able to stop the flow of thought, chitta vritti, then he is established. So when a person stops the flow of thoughts, that means starts living in present moment, moment to moment, then he is established in the real self, swarupa. Think, what is the swarupa? What is my own form? What is swa? Swa means own, rupa is form. Swa means the self or soul, and the definition of self is Satchit Ananda, eternity, consciousness, and supreme bliss. So when I see my real form, how can I be in falsehood or illusion? How can I be in ignorance? How can I be in sorrow? These are not my form. If I am angry, if I am egotistic, if I am jealous, I am not really in my real form. The real form is peace, bliss, joy, consciousness, supreme bliss. Tadadrashtu swarupe avasthanam. So when we start watching the breath constantly, we start living in present moment, and this present moment, living in practice, practicing living in this present moment, leads us to that state, tadadrashtu swarupe avasthanam, when mind becomes more and more calm automatically, and we have the glimpses of our real self. So we need to start practicing this, watching the breath. We will forget many times, no doubt. But again and again, we have to remind ourselves and practice it. Living in present. And this is what is called spiritual life. So living in present moment is the spiritual life. So let us practice it. I am praying to God and all the masters to give us all-round development, more love, inner strength to practice, meditate, be more humble and loving. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha, Sarve Santu Niramayaha, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Makaschid Dukkha Bhag Bhavet. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Let all become happy and healthy, loving, noble, and compassionate. Let there be no suffering or sorrow. Let there be more love, peace, harmony within and everywhere. Om Amen. Thank you. Be happy. Stay safe. Thank you all.